Hi, my name is Chris Cyro. In this REST API feature video, I'm going to show you how to create and get entries. In this example, I'm going to show you how to create and get an entry using the REST API. For this, I'm going to use a simple purchase order and line item form. Here's a quick look at what the purchase order looks like. Nothing too complicated, just a short description field and a GUID. And just for the UI, I have a little table field here to show its related line items. Here is where the line items are. Again, fairly straightforward. A short description, the purchase order ID to link it back, the line number, quantity, unit price, total price, and it has its own GUID as well. Here we are in Postman. I'm going to create a new entry on the purchase order form. I've already logged in and copied the value of the token to the environment variable, so that's already set. I'm not going to show you that. So we're going to start with creating that new entry. In order to do that, I need to do a post to the form. So I'm going to start by typing in the URL here. Switch it to the post method. First, I'm going to add the authorization header. That way the server knows who I am. And then here's the variable. And in order to type send the JSON document, I'm going to use this raw editor. I'm going to change this to JSON. That'll add the correct content type so the server knows what I'm sending it. And it changes this editor to format JSON documents. In order to create a new purchase order, I only need one field, the short description field. So I'm going to start by typing values. And again, I only need one field, short description. I'm going to call it test PO. Number one. Once I've got this all set up, the AR server returns me a 201 response, letting me know that something was created. But notice I don't get anything back. I actually have to go to the headers and look at this location header. It tells me when a new resource has been created. So I can actually copy this and go get that entry I just created. Switch it to get. I actually don't need to send the content type, so I'll get rid of that. But I'm going to need to keep the authorization header. And now I actually have the purchase order that I just created. It shows me all of the values, request ID, submitter, and so on, the short description that I entered, and the automatically generated GUID, which I'm going to copy for use later when I create some line items. Now I'm going to create a few line item entries associated to that purchase order we just created. Again, we need to do a post to the line item form. So I'm going to start there. Switch this back. Switch this to post. Again, showing you I've already got the token in the header. Back to JSON here. And now I'm going to create a line item. That form needs a few more fields than the purchase order does. So I'm going to start with the basic entry format. And now the fields. Need short description again. I'm going to start with laptop configuration number 2, the purchase order ID, which we copied from the purchase order, the line number, start with line number 20, then the quantity. Just one, unit price. And the total price. Now I'll hit send and create a new line item. Again, the error server sends me back 201, and in the headers field for the location, I can see and there's the line item we created. I'm going to create a few more line items using the history that Postman has. And I'm just going to change a few of the values here. Docking station, line number 30, and it's, let's say, $99. Again, created. And then a monitor. I'm actually going to make this one line number 10. And it's a decent monitor, so $199.